Okay, it's working. Top of her class, outstanding student. This is how her business professors from accounting, finance, entrepreneurship, to management have consistently described her. So I pondered about these two phrases. What did they see in their classes that has led them to come up with the same conclusions that I did? Allow me to represent what they may have seen by sharing what I have seen through my experiences with the student. To start off, she received the top grades and produced the most impressive and creative assignments and projects in my classes. This takes tremendous amount of energy, effort, and grit. However, if this was the only way in which George Fox University measures an outstanding top student, then the institution misses the point, and the student misses the point. From what I have witnessed, the student went beyond her performance. She is one curious soul, whose eyes lit up in class when she discovers a new idea. She was excited to connect and relate what she has learned to her experiences outside the class. For example, she has worked on various class projects, ranging from marketing, real estate investment, food, manufacturing, and vacation rental businesses. What was impressive for me was how she eagerly implemented what she learned into her own music and wedding cake business, and even her brother's app business. In all that I observed her do, she pushed and challenged herself, but having fun was always a part of that equation. For example, the phrase, "This is fun," was a part of her everyday language in my classes. Her genuine smiles and laughs were endearing and an asset to the classroom atmosphere. She also humbly owned up to anything she believed she could do better because she saw them as a learning and growing opportunity. What I loved most about the quality was that she was wise to not dwell on the past, but to move on to achieve the greater goal. She understood this. In these ways, I can only imagine how she has encouraged countless professors and students through her presence at Fox. These examples I share with you are the fruits of her Christ-like spirit. She is joyful, kind, humble, patient, and honest. She is the kind of salt and light I pray for in my students. Her saltiness makes me thirsty to understand where her source of light and joy comes from. So you see, a student does not start with the top grades and productivity, then becomes outstanding. The top grades and productivity are only one natural byproduct of her character and who she is. I think by now, you know who you are. You have truly earned this title as the outstanding student at the College of Business. It is my honor to congratulate you, Rikki Kazmierowicz.
They showed us what it means to be a follower of Christ, how to embrace and how to love others. From the beginning, Josh's Accounting 272 class showed us what hard work really meant. I hope you know we took that project seriously. Steve taught us how to debate. Unfortunately, he's not here, but if you took his class, you know. Ryan taught us that risk is the chance that reality will turn out differently than we expect and that we should be prepared to embrace it. Dr. DVD taught us so much about China, we should all be honorary citizens. Sarah taught us that you can never do enough research. And if you're me, then a well-timed hug is sometimes what a student having a bad day needs. Even more than that, they all taught us that hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work as hard. So college was our time to make mistakes over and over again, to gain a coffee addiction, spend too much money in chapters and coffee cottage, stand in the rain at football games, make friends with people that in 20 years we'll be able to say, oh yes, we We met in college. It was our time to try out different majors, wardrobes, nicknames, our time to explore and to learn, so that today, when our friends, our parents' friends ask us, what do you want to be when you grow up? We know. Thank you so much. Congratulations.